Tuesday Reviews Day. Woo! Anyway, this is Tanner's Chocolate Assortment. It's an assortment of high-quality branded misshaped chocolates. I don't know why it's called Tanner's. I'm sure it's got nothing to do with the golden-eyed private dancer who was simply the best butcher cat on the rain against a window. Or Tanner's. I'm gonna see what kind of assortment we've got. It's got original mix written on it. Yeah, sometimes you get a lot of Cadbury stuff in this. I think it's stuff that normally the staff would get, you know, the misshapes. And then I thought, do you know what, we could make some money off of this. Let's see what sort of assortment we've got. Ooh, there's new stuff in here. I can tell you that straight away. What have we got? What is that? That is some kind of... What is that? Something reading a book? There's loads of these things. I wonder what these are. There's loads of them. Let's put them into rows. I've got two bags because I wanted to see what there was. Now, normally what you get in these is either a really good, genuinely good mix or a lot of crap. Hard toffees, I don't really like. That's a really weird one in this one, isn't it? A dog reading a book. I wonder what chocolate that's out of. I wonder where the muscle that... There's loads of these. How is this a misshape? They all look fine. Sometimes what you get is chocolates that look fine, but when you bite into them, there's probably no caramel or there's no chocolate or, you know, whatever the filling is meant to be. Listen, yeah, that is slightly different, isn't it? That's one of them again, isn't it? And that is them. Well, I wouldn't say they're really misshaped. It's not really an assortment, is it? It's just three different ones. Let's see what this is. What is this? Just some flavourless thing with my teeth marks in it now. That is just... That's boring. What is this? There's no Cadbury things in there. Do you recognise the shapes of any of these chocolates? Let me know in the comment section down below. Where do you think these are from? This is quite chewy. It took me a good minute or so to eat that. Let's see what's in the middle ones. Oh! Blood! No. What is that? Oh! That's like a very mild strawberry taste. Oh, these are quite nice. Yeah, no strawberry. Mmm. All right. Mmm. Very nice. Just chocolate. I'm gonna come back to that because these are lovely, but they taste quite strong and I wanna know if I can recognise the chocolate. Let's open another one. See what's in this bag. Now it's quite rare to get two bags of the same thing, but you watch, I'll be really miffed if it's the same stuff. Oh no, there's something new. Not a lot though, is there? There's even more of these. I'm using the former Ashens plate. He doesn't use his plate anymore. Maybe he's seen randomly one of my videos and thought, I don't want to be associated with him. There's absolutely loads of these. The factory must have had a really bad day with them. Look at that. Just pile them up. Look at that. Oh, it's a shell. It's a shell. I've got a feeling that's going to be caramel filled or meant to have been caramel filled. It's not a very good mix today, folks. Is it? Look, it's just all the same stuff. I'll tell you what there used to be loads of. Used to get a lot of the caramel twisted, you know, the what they're called, cream egg twisted. You know, the little ones, what they put in the multi-pack bags. Yeah, it's just all of these again, isn't it? I've got way too many of them now. Far too many of them. It's going off the bloody screen. Well, that's what is this? Oh, it's not caramel filled. It's got some kind of this is horrible. It's got some sort of chocolate filled mix. Did anyone recognize this one before I ate it? This sort of shell design. It's got like a weird chocolatey soft filling that's like a really soft chocolate, but it doesn't taste very nice at all. Incredibly soft, I've got melted all over my fingers. Yeah. Don't like that. I have to come back to this because I'm not too sure what chocolate that is from. So we're gonna go say next, we're gonna move over to some ice cream from Lidl. Oh, by the way, you get these for £1 from Poundland, Iceland. Oh, but I know this is Poundworld then. And any cheap shop really, you'll find these. It's quite hit and miss. I would give this a mediocre. These are quite nice. Those are I'll probably end up throwing away. They're not anything amazing, and they're really chewy. Let's come back to the bear. Let's move the former Ashens plate out the way and bring in these Chewy Louie, how you treat me? A strawberry and bourbon vanilla ice cream with a crispy glaze. And it's blowing a bubble, so is it bubbly or is it chewy? We don't know. See that, I would call that bubble gum. And it's got this stick that says a bubble gum popsicle. Popsicle is not a word we use in the UK. This is just something that Lidl seems to have genericized into this product. So maybe they sell these in America. Don't know. There's four. A picture so you can see what's in them and what's not in them. There we are. Is it going to focus? Because I'm using my phone camera. I shouldn't have used my phone camera. Skimmed milk. Oh, yeah. Keep frozen. If thawed, do not refreeze. Suitable for vegetarians. Multi-pack. Not to be sold separately. So there's the usual massive barcode. And a barcode on every side. That's how Lidl work. And it's a good idea, isn't it? I don't know why more companies don't do that. Because then when you're scanning it at self-scan, it's just going to be so much easier. Oh, inside we've got Chewy Louie. And yeah. I thought it had two sticks then. She's got the one. This is the picture. And then inside it's got that. A bit pointless, but when you open the packaging, inside you get. Oh. There we go. Oh, God. Oh, that feels weird. It feels weird. Because you'd expect to normally feel. A wooden stick or something, wouldn't you? Anyway, time to turn the camera around. It does smell very bubblegummy. It really does. A good bubblegum flavour. Wow, that is strong. Well, that's good. Sort of pre-cracked on the side, or did I do that? I don't know. That's really nice and refreshing. I like bubble gum flavored sweets and goodies and ice cream. Now, that seems to have dribbled down the stick. I just want to get down to this bottom bit and see what it tastes like. These are very good. It's weird because it says it's strawberry and bourbon vanilla ice cream, but it's almost as if the bubble gum flavour has taken over it somehow. That is really weird. Because I can taste bubble gum. And I'm supposed to be tasting strawberry and bourbon Vanilla ice cream with a crispy glaze. Oh my word! I've coated it in plastic. Look, you peel that bit off, I was just gonna eat it. Oh, that's a bit dangerous. And they accidentally eat plastic. And it didn't tell you anything about it on the back either. So a parent might give this to the kids. And the kid might choke. I'm not going to be able to peel it off. Oh, that's terrible. I nearly ate that. It's not very good, is it? Oh, that's hard. It says serving suggestion. You've got to sit on the ice cream and blow a bubble. I want to blow a bubble. I've got a feeling there's going to be a recall. Or discontinued. I'll tell you what. There's a lot of bubbly. For a kid's ice cream. A real lot. It was too hard to blow a bubble. And this bubble's blue. Why is this bubble blue when this clearly isn't blue? Was it different colours? No. That's hard to do. It's too much, it's too thick. It's not very good bubbly. It says now on the back that you have to unwrap the bubbly. This is rubbish. The bubbly's not good at all. Ice cream's delicious. The bubbly bit is a little bit dangerous and not very tasty or very bubbly-y. My tongue for it, that's rubbish. Oh, what a shame. I've had them in the fridge as well. I've had them in the freezer for well over a week. I was going to do them last week, but I forgot all about them. Anyway, to finish off with, let's try this chocolate and see if we know what it is. It's not Cadbury, it's not Nestle. It tastes like nothing. It's probably something out of an advent calendar from about 3 years ago. And they've been sent in. Because you have no idea of dates of anything on this stuff. I'm just mashing it against the roof of my mouth and my tongue now. That is not a quality chocolate. No. That's just some cheap tat from somewhere. Anyway, that was today's Tuesday Reviews Day of Tina Turner's chocolate assortment and Lidl's Gelati Chewy Louie. Ice cream good, stick crap. There we go. Thanks for watching. Scrass, bye. Don't forget to bail me. Bye.